Hello and welcome everybody. When you speaking with Muslim about their religion, they always jump and ask you where all of this came from. Is it came by a chance? There must be someone who created this universe. This type of counter argument does not make sense logically. What is the relationship between religions and the universe came from nothing or by a chance? You can believe that the universe has a creator without the need of believing in the religion. So when we speak about the problem in the religions, asking the question where all of this came from does not make sense and do not prove anything, because talking about the religion have nothing to do with atheists. The discussion about God's existence is different from the discussion about the religion's claim. But yet the most used argument that Muslims always bring is the problem of evil. There is a reason why those Muslim apologists tend to go with this argument about the God existence and the problem of evil. Because those who were ashamed of their religion, this is the best way to sell the religious to the people. By making a channel and saying, I am going to fight atheist belief, and he make himself a deist defending all the religions. Those people came and tell you, Hitler came and killed millions of people. Stalin killed millions of people. There are people who committed a mass massacre. If there is no God, they will all die without no consequences. Where is the justice in all of that? They just kill a lot of people and die without consequences. In the face of it, people can have the illusion that this argument is logical, but the problem here is, does life itself have a justice? Does the world we live in today look like we have a justice? Or life is a chaos and people make the laws to make justice by themselves. Life itself have no justice and evil is everywhere. The system of life is built on killing other species to survive. Can you tell me where is the justice in the nature and between the creatures that survive on killing each other? Where is the justice in case of someone suffer entire his life and when he die he go into hell forever? Or the opposite, either case, going to hell or the paradise forever on the basis that you believe or not believe is an illogical. Life is full with evil. Therefore, this question about justice, they should be asking their God about it, not us atheists. Ask Allah about his justice in this life because he said he is just. Where is the justice on someone born and suffer for 1 hour, then he die? The Jew who die in the Nazi Holocaust, normally, if Islam is the religion of the true God, where do you think they will go after death according to Islamic belief? They will go to the Holocaust of Allah that going to last forever. They experienced the Holocaust of Hitler just to found another fire and Holocaust waiting for them. Prepared by Allah, God of Islam, does only accept Muslim to the paradise. Where is the justice here? There is an example of some people can enter the paradise without knowing Islam, and I found it bizarre when I looked at it, especially not too many people talking about it. There is a lot of people die without hearing that there is a religion called Islam or someone called Muhammad, and yet they still can enter the paradise. So what is the sin of people who heard about Islam and do not believe in it? They will go to hell. Those who not heard about Islam and they still have a chance to enter the paradise. Do you know what's going to happen to those people who not heard about Islam? They will have a test or something like interview in the day of the judgment. Imagine yourself one of those people the day of the judgment, and people ask you, what do you have? Straight path or Lord enter you. Straight path here is the Sirat. Al-Sirat. You tell them, no, I just have interview. I never heard of Muhammad and his religion. We as well want this interview. Why there is no justice even after life? Why Muslim go and preach their religion to other people just to trap them in the day of the judgment? Why can't they just let them live their life and face this simple exam after life? Is there a justice in Islam? If there is, outcome is going to be the same for some people. There you will realize that Islam is a joke, and the person who was talking about the judgment after life have no clue about the logic or the reality we are living in. Where is the justice in someone lived his life, does not care about the religion or the existence of gods, and after life he is going to face a simple exam to enter the paradise, and someone heard about Islam and he have no choice only to believe before his death. But yet the biggest problem Allah justice have is the family you born in and the time you came in. Where is the justice if you born in a non-Muslim family? 99% you will die non-Muslim and you go into hell. And someone was born with a lottery card that's guaranteed to him enter into the paradise by 99%. Just because he have a chance to born in a Muslim family. If we say that Islam is the religion of the truth, mean the people who born Muslim, they have a big advantage on non-Muslim. What is the sin of billion of people who born in a non-Muslim family and they have to make an effort to found Islam and to believe in it? They will tell you they have to know about Islam and Muhammad. According to Islam, anybody heard the name of Islam and name of Muhammad, he is already accounted for those who have to believe in Islam in order to enter the paradise. Today, the most people in the earth heard about Islam, and yet the majority of them, they don't believe in it. And why Muslims have to do nothing to enter the paradise just because they are very lucky to born and raised as a Muslims, and yet the rest of the world have to change their belief and make a decision based on scripture that is 1400 years old. Them sin is they don't have a chance as a Muslim have. Here is appear to you that everything in this religion is not correct, cause there is no justice and your belief is according to the time and the family you born in, the environment and the culture and the circumstances that surround you. There is a multiple facts that decide your eternal destiny. Conclusion here is, there is no justice in all of this, no matter what you try to make sense of it. You only going to come up with more question than answer. Thank you guys for watching and see you again.